So, Diwali is approaching. A happy Diwali to all of you. And today, a lot of people are saying that we should not burn crackers. Celebrate a pollution-free Diwali. Don't say no to crackers. They are telling us that we should not burn crackers. We should give it to that money to poor people, etc., etc. So I will give a reply to them, those people. I have written whole essay on this, and that I'm going to read it in front of you. Our reply to those who tell us say no to crackers, celebrate a pollution-free Diwali. They say fireworks cause pollution. So what are my views on this? I will tell you now. But research report from IIT Kanpur report that the firework cause only 0.4% of the total annual pollution. This is report from IIT Kanpur. You can check it on Delhi government site. The major sources of pollution are industries, vehicles, building construction, burning of garbage. Domestic pollution is also about 4%. You can think how less pollution firecrackers cause. So on what basis they tell us to boycott firecrackers on Diwali? The so-called environment lovers, why do they only become so environment conscious on Diwali? Because on no other occasion do they tell us this, like New Year or other minor occasions like wedding, etc. Whole year they will not care for pollution. When they are enjoying their comfort zone, they are using their cars, okay, ACs, refrigerators, and all sorts of luxury. Then they do not care for pollution. But these vehicles and all these ACs, these cause far more lot pollution than firecrackers. But they will not ban those things or try to moderate the use of those things. No, firecrackers should be banned. When I was in primary, I was taught that fireworks cause pollution in a subject EBS. I don't understand on what basis they said this, because analytics says something else. I agree that fireworks cause a temporary pollution that lasts for about a week, but it is far more beneficial than its harmful effects. Indian traditions and customs are not made like this only. They have a scientific importance, which I will discuss now. We all live in India, where there are monsoons in the months June, July, August, and September. Rains not only clean the air by dissolving harmful gases and particulate matter, but also due to moisture, bacteria and viruses breed too. Even it is a breeding season for mosquitoes and other insects. Now, this is the season where people start catching viral infection and diseases like malaria and dengue become prominent. Diwali comes in the month of October and November. Now, what happens? The smoke of the fireworks actually acts as an air disinfectant. Let's see how and understand the chemistry behind it. Fireworks generally contain a small amount of sulfur. When they burn, sulfur dioxide gas is formed, which is a mild bleaching agent. This gas enters their bacteria and viruses and kills them by bleaching action. See, here I have written the equation. SO2 plus 2H2O gives H2SO4 plus 2 nascent hydrogen atom. This nascent hydrogen temporarily bleaches the cells of bacteria, virus, small insect like mosquitoes, and they get killed. After a few days, this all gases spread into the atmosphere and get diluted. Now some may point that SO2 is poisonous. But let me tell you, the concentration of SO2 to kill a human being is not to that extent that it can kill. You can check on Wikipedia, the concentration of any poison has to be at a certain limit to kill or give some effect to that person or an animal. Even cyanide has some limit. If you consume cyanide less than that limit, it will not affect you. But if you consume cyanide to that limit, it will kill you. You can check on it on Wikipedia. Now, who says that it is harmful? It is harmful to us. But have you ever noticed the warning sign on mosquito repellents? They have far more harmful chemicals than SO2, which affect humans if they are exposed to it for a long time. And these stupid repellents do not kill mosquitoes. You might have seen other pollutant of firecrackers is smoke, solid particles suspended in air. But don't you think that the hair in our noses will filter it? These particles are capable of absorbing moisture and either settle down or go up into the atmosphere where clouds are formed. Also, you must note that small insects are found dead on Diyas, the next day of Diwali. So, mosquitoes are getting killed. It's beneficial. You cry that don't burn firecrackers, cause pollution, it is harmful to us. Actually, it is giving protection from the mosquitoes and even killing the bacteria and viruses in the air, which is saving you some viral and other diseases like dengue and mosquito. Now people say, what about noise pollution? All fireworks do not make noise. Which make noise are under the decibel limit standards made by the government. If there will be no sound, there won't be the joy of festival. It will look very silent. Obviously, firecrackers are a sign of prosperity and happiness. And if there will be no sound, how it will look? Silent. It will look like a funeral. Animal lovers. Now, some animal lovers are there who say that animals are getting disturbed. And I would like to point Anushka Sharma for that, who posted a video on YouTube last year where she was criticizing fireworks on Diwali because the noise hurts to animals, showing that she cares for animals. Let me expose her. But she is a non-vegetarian. Yes, she is a non-vegetarian. She loves chicken, fish, etc. Are they not animals whom she ate for her taste and pleasure? And we are not banging crackers on their ears. And these animals hide away at that time, where they are not affected by the noise. Why these animal lovers do not post against Bakrid? Why do they care? Why do their care dies when an innocent animal is killed slowly by cutting his throat, but not the spine? It's called halal. Causing the animal to die slowly and with pain. Kehte hai na, tadap tadap ke marna. All this hypocrisy, they just want to become famous by doing such acts that they become a matter of discussion. So all these people who are telling you to stop, don't burn crackers, this is just for popularity only. Maybe that they are telling you not to burn firecrackers and they will burn thousands of crackers on Diwali for their amusement and any other that you don't burn crackers. And there are many people who will say, don't burn crackers. Maybe they are not burning. But tell me one thing. If you are not burning crackers, so you will not let others also burn. If you don't like crackers, so it's important that the other one also don't celebrate. Everyone has the right to celebrate festivals in their own manner. If you get happiness from making rangoli, you will make rangoli. For some people, eating sweets is happiness. For some people, shopping. For some people, find happiness in firecrackers. Now, take my example. Take my word one. For example, people start saying that suppose you like sweets. You like sweets on Diwali, and people start saying you don't eat sweets, it will cause you diabetes. Don't eat sweets. Boycott sweets. Okay? How will you feel? Not telling me how will your Diwali mood will be. The same thing we feel when someone says don't burn firecrackers, because that is happiness for us. Children, we light diyas, children have no interest in it. For them, Diwali is the festival of firecrackers only. because they find happiness. For their happiness, can't you take some only 1 or 2 day discomfort? Their happiness is not important. Only because now you have got bored with the firecrackers, you will not let children also burn. And now, what should be done to control pollution? That also I will discuss in this video. Firecracker ban is not a solution to pollution control, because whole year we are not burning firecrackers. It's just a matter of 1 night or 2 nights. And its effect also gets diminished after a few days. And what about whole year? For that no one cares. Only on Diwali people become environment friendly. Now I tell you what are the ways. Pollution can be reduced and controlled by many effective ways rather than banning firecrackers on Diwali. Last year Supreme Court banned firecrackers on Diwali, but was pollution controlled? No. Still it increased. Why? Because on Diwali people go for shopping and you can see that traffic jams on roads during festive season. The more my vehicles use, more pollution, and firecrackers are blamed. There are effective methods to reduce pollution in cities, and the best is to plant more and more trees. Yes, you should plant more and more trees, everyone knows. And that is, like I live in a city, Lucknow, I don't live in Delhi. So here the pollution is not due to industries. Very few industries are there around Lucknow. Mainly Lucknow's pollution due to vehicles and deforestation. So here air contains generally nitrogen dioxide, that is vehicular pollution, carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide, and dust particles and smoke particles, and CO2 level in the Lucknow air is slightly higher due to deforestation. Now, one more for Delhi NCR, the condition is such that the air is so polluted. If firecrackers are burned over there, the pollution will rise from to so much level that you won't be able to breathe the next day. That's why Supreme Court banned crackers over there. But what should be done was that the industries that surround Delhi NCR that are using petroco. Now, what is petroco? You can see Abhishek Shukla's video on petrochemical industries in the description below. I have given the link in the description. You can see. I am telling you what is petrochemical in short. You can watch the whole documentary on Abhishek Shukla's channel. Petrochemical is a sort of petroleum waste which is now industries are using as in the place of coal. Petrochemical contains about 42,000 ppm of sulfur, and the permitted limit is only 4000 ppm of sulfur in coal. So that is more than 10 times greater, and it is banned in India, but companies are using it. You know, the corruption, nothing can be done for that. So one more idea I give you, that the smoke that is going from chimneys usually contain gases like carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide and water vapor and some smoke particles too. So what can be done? The smoke, the chimney could be connected with a compressor, and the gas can be collected, liquefied and collected in tanks. That gases can be sent to a chemical factory, and that gases will be used as a raw material to manufacture chemicals. They will separate the gases by fractional distillation, and then they will use CO2 to make fire extinguishers, sulfur dioxide to make sulfuric acid. But no, that idea will not strike anyone. Here, most of the citizens are illogical, don't want to use their brain. Just what is going trendy, they catch that. If people are going and jumping in well, they will also go and jump in well. They will not think that what is happening. They will not use their brain. Here people are so illogical. Problem is there. Therefore, I conclude that fireworks are boycotted because it has become mentality of Indian people due to education, which tells us this, and this all work is of the missionaries. Foreigners are always jealous of our traditions and customs. Therefore, they have planted seeds to destroy the beauty of Hinduism, in which this is one of the many ways. In foreign countries, Europe, Australia, Dubai, Japan, China, Russia, USA, etc. also fireworks shows are organized by government or community in charge, but no one boycotts them. Why only in India so? That is the reason that firecrackers are far better than ours. In other countries, pyrotechnic labs are there. Over there, such activities are promoted. Why not so in India? Here, on Diwali, I see don't burn firecrackers. On Mahashivratri, don't offer milk, give it to poor, holy water vessel, all this on Hindu festivals only. If you don't celebrate, that doesn't mean the other person also don't celebrate. Now many people say firecrackers are waste of money. So they say that wasting money on firecrackers, it's better to give that money to poor children. So have you ever gone to Shivkashi factory and seen? Their workers are also poor. They earn their livelihood by making these firecrackers. And by boycotting them, you want to take away their livelihood. You want to take away their bread and you want to take their food and water. What do you want? They are not poor. And one more thing. You tell me, that is it better to buy 1,000 rupees crackers or to spend thousands of rupees on dengue treatment or malaria treatment? I think prevention is better than cure. And one more thing, if Supreme Court is really very conscious about health of citizens, why didn't he ban cigarettes and alcohol? Is that not injurious to health? That is not banned. Firecrackers are banned. We don't celebrate a one-day festival also. Once in a year. More than wishing happy Diwali, they are saying don't burn firecrackers. Nowadays I'm hearing this only. हैप्पी दिवाली की जगह लोग ये ज्यादा बोलते हैं कि पटाखे का बहिष्कार करो. वाह भैया, मतलब अगर तुम ना छुड़ाते तो हम भी ना छुड़ाएं. तो ये जितने भी लोग हैं, देखो जिसको पटाखे, जो जिस मेंटालिटी का है वो उसी मेंटालिटी का रहेगा. ठीक है, आप उसको चेंज नहीं कर सकते. लेकिन भैया, अगर आपको अच्छे नहीं लगते पटाखे, ठीक है, मत छुड़ाओ, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. लेकिन हमें अच्छे लगते हैं, हमें छुड़ाने दो. हमें क्यों बार बार बोलते हो, मूड खराब हो जाता है, हम आपके वजह से पटाखे छोड़ना तो बंद कर नहीं देंगे, फालतू में क्यों मूड खराब करते हो. सही में पता है, हम लोग साल भर से दिवाली का वेट करते हैं कि दिवाली आएगी पटाखे फोड़ेंगे, क्योंकि हमें उससे हमारे लिए अम्यूजमेंट भी है ही क्या. मिडिल क्लास फैमिली के हमारे पास इतना, आपके लिए पास तो अम्यूजमेंट के लिए बहुत कुछ है, हम लोग के पास क्या है? हम लोग के लिए यही छोटी छोटी खुशियां हैं जिससे हमें जीवन जीने का सहारा मिलता है. तो मुझे बस अपने वीडियो में यही कहना था. बाकी आप जो हिपोक्रेसी है उस पर मैंने लिंक्स दिए हुए हैं नीचे. एडवांटेज ऑफ फायर करके आपको मेरे पर विश्वास नहीं हो रहा है तो आप नीचे जो लिंक्स दिए हैं उसमें सुधीर चौधरी की रिपोर्ट भी है फायर क्रैकर्स के ऊपर, वो आप देख सकते हैं. जी न्यूज़ पे उन्होंने डाली थी, मैंने लिंक दे रखे हैं डिस्क्रिप्शन में, आप जाके चेक कर सकते हैं. सो हैप्पी दिवाली टू ऑल ऑफ यू. और पटाखे छुड़ाना तो जम के छुड़ाइए, क्योंकि इससे मच्छर मरते हैं और आप बायोलॉजिकली प्रोटेक्ट नहीं कर रहे हैं सबको. सो और अब क्या बोलूं मैं. हैप्पी दिवाली, बाय बाय.